the idea of a veteran coming back, what made you think of that?
Well, there's a newspaper article that I saw that vets were coming back and they were getting discharged after getting injured. And then when they'd come back, they would lose their signing bonus. And a lot of these guys were having to live in their cars and things like that. And I was thinking, man, that's horrible if you have to come back from getting injured and then you lose your money. So that's kind of where the story began.
How does it feel to act and direct the movie?
I mean, like, we've been working on the film for so long that I know exactly what I want. So when we actually filmed it, I knew where I was going to go.
Eviction notice?
A joke?
I hear you need a job. I need a new courier. My clients are very wealthy people who don't like their business being spread around town. Keep your mouth shut.
Where's your briefcase?
You always keep me smiling.
You're Shane, man. You're good old Shane.
I'm not stopping until we get the old house back. That's a promise.
Need this done quick. No mess-ups. I'm going to hit the road. Go to Bakersfield. Palmdale, and then come back here to find my living.
What about the whole car tie-in, like the Mustang? Was that? Did you write the script as well?
Yes. Well, I came up with a story, and I wanted a car, a hot rod car.
So that was your idea?
Yeah, some type of car. I didn't know what we were going to get, but met Francis over here, and he had the car.
Actually, this young lady's car, and she built it from scratch.
You built the car?
Yes. With the help of Chuck, the mechanic.
Wow. Yeah. So are you a mechanic?
Aspiring.
Aspiring mechanic?
Yeah.
I love it when people restore cars, but they get in and do the actual work.
Yeah.
The mechanical work.
I started doing that after this car. I got it the same year, but a fastback. We first got this car that's in this movie delivered. It was the first time I took it to the mechanic. You know, they write down the name of the paint color that it is. It was so many different paint colors that they just wrote down vomit as the paint color.
Were they trying to restore the original paint or find out what it was or something?
I wasn't going for the original style. I wanted to kind of make it a souped-up, awesome Mustang. You know, I didn't want to stick to any rules, so
cool.
They really helped me make it a badass machine.
So how did they find you, or did you find them, or what? How did you?
They found me through this gentleman over here. Yeah. We have the same mechanic, so.
You have the same mechanic.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, who actually has a 50-year history with Mustangs.
No kidding.
He's been a Mustang specialist since they were new here in Hollywood. He actually used to race with Steve McQueen. He used to teach Elvis Kung Fu. Incredible guy called Chuck. Chuck Sordo on Fairfax, right in the middle of Hollywood here.
Wow.
And the car was a gift for her birthday from me to her, but it was a wreck. I mean, it was smashed to pieces, everything, every nut and bolt, everything, motor, transmission, the lot on the whole car was built custom for her.
What more could you ask for? Something you can really build from the bottom up, right?
It was amazing. It was an amazing experience. And driving that car, that was the best car I've ever driven in my entire life.
No kidding.
Oh, it was so manly.
I guess it has a stick shift, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Well,
couldn't do without.
Originally automatic, but she had it built as a stick shift.
Oh, cool. So how big is the engine in it?
It was
a 351.
Yeah, it was a 351.
351.
Yeah.
Is there any racing in the movie with it? I mean, you don't wreck it or anything.
The movie, Michael actually took it a lot easier. I said to him, hey, nail it. And he does go fast. There is some very fast driving. But he didn't absolutely hooliganize it, which we said he could, but he took it a little bit easy.
That's where the car really shines.
Oh, wait, when you stick it.
In hooliganery.
Yeah, when you show the muscle. Absolutely.
Yeah, you got to create smoke coming out of those back wheels when you drive that. That's good.
So have you guys seen the movie yet?
No. I'm
so
one of the producers, and I haven't actually seen it yet.
Without Francis, we wouldn't have the same movie. It would have been my truck.
That could have been a cool movie.
It would have been a different
movie. It's nice to have a Mustang.
Yeah.
This is Drew Holguin, and He's in the movie.
Oh, really?
He plays a little boy whose ball rolls into Shane, who's in a wheelchair, and he's a little scared because his ball is rolled into this vet, and he doesn't know what his reaction is going to be.
Did you enjoy being in the film?
Yeah.
Have you acted before?
No.
You gonna do it again?
Maybe. Tell him what you like to do.
I like to make video games.
Oh, cool.
He designs. He's a designer. Wow. He's already designed two games.
So where did you find him?
This is my grandson.
Oh, my goodness. Isn't that wonderful?
It is. His mom was the production designer, and so she teaches technical theater arts.
I run a pre-professional and college preparatory school within a school. At South Almani High School, they have a special program called the Theater Arts and Design Academy, and I'm a stagecraft teacher, and I was fortunate enough to be able to bring on an entire summer school class, about 12 students, mostly graduated seniors, who were able to work on the film and get a feature credit, which is absolutely fantastic. David actually is in IOTC now, in 33, and yeah.
Several of her alumni students worked on the film, and we've now used them after they graduated her school to do makeup. We just did a commercial shoot, and they were
so
in that too.
It's amazing how you got these favors from people to be on the crew.
Well, the students actually were getting credit for school.
I'm Toda. I was script supervisor, and it was my first time working also in a feature film, and I loved it. Thanks to my teacher, Jen. Thank you so much. I love her.
Their teacher was on set, and they worked for 3-4 months on pre-production. They built appliances for bullet wounds. They built a fake leg for a body that you'll see in the film.
If I get what belongs to me, you don't get hurt. But if I don't, so just tell me where to look.
Hi, I'm Nancy Fragoso. I was part of the crew doing wardrobe and makeup with Jen and Tiffany here.
Hi, my name is Tiffany Anguiano, and yeah, as they said previously, I did makeup and wardrobe, and I got to be the girl in the elevator and Sarkis' receptionist, so that was really cool. But yeah, I can't thank enough Linda, Michael, Jen. It's a great opportunity. Thank you.
So they worked really hard on props and wardrobe and makeup.
We try really hard to give him as many work experiences as we possibly can, because there's this wonderful industry out here that without this program, they would have no access to. And so we're just hoping that amid the budget crisis, we can keep this program operational, which has been tough because we've lost a lot of our outside funding. And with the school system the way it is, it's not really sustainable because we're losing a lot of our elective teachers. So we hope it keeps going, because this has been really great for our students. We have a lot of kids in the industry now who've come out over the last 5 to 7 years. And we have a lot of kids in college working on their theater and film degrees.
You got a few Hollywood veteran actors.
Oh, yes,
involved.
We do.
I'm Toshi Toda. I play the bad guy. And I enjoy the killing people. Usually I play Japanese businessmen, so it's a big change for me.
Hi, my name is Kenny Lombino, and I played Dr. DeLuca. Yeah, it was a great movie to be asked to be in and to perform in. It was a lot of fun, a lot of talented people, and I was very honored to do it. Thank you.
My name is Koji Wada. I got to play Taro. It was my first time being in a feature film. It was really nice.
Hi, my name is Yaz Takahashi, and I played Shin, and I'm so happy to be part of this movie.
Hi guys, my name is Yoshi, and I play Yuuta. I got killed by Katsuro. I'm glad to be here, and then thank you for Michael and Linda.
What is his name?
Shane. That's all I know.
So, you and Shane, did you plan this?
No! No!
You look like you need to cool off. The water's great.
Hi, I'm Jeanette Steiner, and I play Cindy. And your English is great, actually. yeah, I flew from Thailand to be here to see this, and I'm really excited.
How were you able to swing that?
Well, we did this film as a SAG ultra-low budget film. Hello, James. And as a SAG ultra-low budget, you are able to mix both SAG and non-SAG
right,
actors.
Right.
And so we were able to attract some really good veteran actors. They like the script. Yeah. It's a good story. Toshi Toda was this gentleman here.
Yeah.
He was in Letters to Iwo Jima and Crank.
Right.